Welcome to St. David's and our Blue Christmas service this evening. For those who have suffered loss, the holidays actually celebrate feelings of sadness. Being surrounded by happy Christmas carols and holiday parties may cause people to mask their feelings or even create some shame around having them. However, a loved one is no longer present to celebrate the holiday. There is often guilt, sadness, and loneliness as we grieve. For many, Christmas is not the most wonderful time of the year, as the song goes. A Blue Christmas service can offer some healing and hope. The idea behind the Blue Christmas service is to create space for the acknowledgement of the heaviness often carried during this season, as well as offering the hope that Jesus gives. Our society has become one of masking emotions that are sometimes considered negative. The Bible clearly acknowledges, celebrates, and makes space for pain, struggle, hardship, and tears, and so should we. Science too is catching up to the Bible, as recent studies confirmed that the claim of your happiness pops us psychologically isn't healthy for us physically, socially, or spiritually. And that putting on a smile without making space for the toughness of life actually leads to more and possibly even deeper unhappiness. The Blue Christmas service is a beautiful way to make space during the Advent season for those suffering any kind of loss. Whether the loss of a person, a dream, finances, stability, health, or more. So please remember those tonight with love as we begin our service. Please join us as we celebrate those that we have lost, but still love with every breath that we take. Service will begin in just a second. Blessed are you, holy and living one. In the time of our sorrowing, God is there.
There in the grace of God.
There in words spoken with compassion.
There in the quiet places of the heart, we call treasured memories.
Yes, God is there, and God is here. Come, gracious God, come in quiet hope. Come in gentle assurance. Come in tender mercy. Come with healing to make us whole. Please be seated.
Thank you. Creator God, lover of the universe, we come to you in this quiet place, seeking your reassurance and your hope. We come in the midst of noise, listening for your gentle heartbeat. To those who are chilled by grief and pain, bring the warmth of your love. To those who are overwhelmed by feelings that exhaust and stifle, bring the cooling breeze of your love. To those who are caught in the glare of expectations, bring the comforting darkness of your love. To those who find themselves in shadows of anxiety, bring the morning dawn of your love. Breathe courage into our day. Whisper strength into our dreams. We ask these things in the name of your child, Jesus, who was born into a chaotic world of birth, death, and rebirth, just like today.
Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. Surely God is my salvation. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. And you will say in that day, give thanks to the Lord. Call on his name. Make known his deeds among the nations. Proclaim that his name is exalted. Sing praises to the Lord, for he has done gloriously. Let this be known in all the earth. Shout aloud and sing for joy, O royal Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
Let us read the psalm responsibly by that verse. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come?
My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
God will not let your foot be moved, and the one who watches over you will not fall asleep.
Behold, the God of peace watch over Israel, shall neither slumber nor sleep.
The Holy One watches over you. The Holy One is your shade at your right hand. God shall preserve you from all evil. It is God who shall keep you safe.
God shall watch over you in the morning.
Where are you, God? Are you hiding? Has it become too difficult to show your face around here? There was a time when I would not have minded your absence, when I was young, a different spirit being within, and I was strong and needed less. Not so now. I really need you. I need someone to help carry these tired bones one more time around the block. I need someone to fashion words for all who ask me how I am, expecting faith and piety to flow. Yes, there's a weariness upon me now, and I would like a day's rest. Rest from the emptiness, and rest from this hollow ache. Rest from uncertainty, rest from my own questioning. Oh, it's okay. I know you're there. And all in all, I know you care. It's just that it turned out differently, you know? So I will wait for you to come, and I will sing the song of faith till love is born and life is whole again and journey's end is won. A reading from Luke, the birth of John the Baptist. Now the time came for Elizabeth to give birth, and she bore a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown his great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her. On the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child, and they were going to name him Zachariah after his father. But his mother said, "No, he is to be called John." They said to her, "None of your relatives has his name." Then they motioned to his father to find out what name he wanted to give him. He asked for a writing tablet and wrote, "His name is John." All of them were amazed. Immediately, his mouth was open and his tongue free, and he began to speak, praising God. Fear came over all their neighbors, and all these things were talked about throughout the entire hill country of Judea. All who heard them pondered them and said, "What then will this child become? For indeed, the hand of the Lord was with him."
This part of the service is normally called a homily or a sermon, but we are here to remember with love those who will not be with us. Always remember, grief is not broken, and it doesn't need fixing, but it can mend it. Grief is a journey that we all must take because we are human and we love, so grief is the journey we must take to learn to live with those memories, both good ones and bad ones. And only then can we start to lessen the hurt and pain. So I would like to read to you tonight a poem by Ted Lauder. God of all seasons and senses, grant us the sense of your timing to submit gracefully and rejoice quietly in the turn of the seasons. In the seasons of short days and long nights, of gray and white and cold, teach us the lessons of endings. Children growing, friends leaving, loved ones dying, grieving over, grudges over, blaming over, excuses over. Oh God, grant us a sense of your timing. In this season of short days and long nights, of gray and white and cold, teach us the lessons of beginnings, that such waiting and endings may be the starting place, a planting of seeds which brings to birth what is ready to be born, something right and just and different, a new song, a deeper relationship, a fuller love, in the fullness of your time. O God, grant us the sense of your time.
We light this first candle to remember those whom we have loved and lost. We pause to remember their names, their faces, their voices, the memories that bind them to us in this season. May God's eternal love surround them. We light the second candle to remember the pain of loss, the loss of relationships, the loss of jobs, the loss of health. We pause to gather up the pain of the past and offer it to God, asking that from God's hand we receive the gift of peace. Refresh, restore, renew us, O God, and lead us into your future. Light this third candle to remember ourselves this Christmas time. We pause and remember these past weeks and months, the disbelief, the anger, the down times, the joy and the sorrow of memories, the hugs and handshakes of family and friends who care for us. We give thanks for all the support we have known. Help us to know eternal love, we pray. Light this fourth candle to remember our faith and the gift of hope that the Christmas story offers to us. We remember that God, who shares our life, promises us a place and time of no more pain and suffering. Let us remember the one who shows us the way, who brings the truth, and who bears the light.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May we be gentle with ourselves, remember it, and the image of God.
May we
know
this world, the hearts cheap, embracing tears, laughter, and all that is true. May the protection of God comfort us. May the courage of Jesus sustain us.
May the tenderness of the Spirit embrace us. Maybe the babe Bethlehem bring us joy. May the youth of Nazareth bring us hope. May the man of Galilee bring us strength. May the risen Lord